Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. Today I have extremely good mood. Yesterday things went quite bad, but today I believe it's going to be so much better situation. Giveaway winner idea, congratulations for you, sir. You're big boys, you know how to enter giveaway. If you want to... Katita? No, what I supposed to do, Katita? You see, even Katita is complaining you are not liking the video. Outrageous, fellas. Katya. Yes. She's up for some attention. So yeah. By the way, fellas, if you did not know, I have a hairy pussy. Here you go. Hop. This is my devil, right? What she is doing, she's all the time running like in the Need for Speed movie, and she's having a great time. And she's probably saying, peasant, let me go. Now she actually enjoyed it. Okay, continue to the video, fellas. What we are going to do now, we are going to play with Almighty Tortoise, and there is two options how the things can go. Option number one is I will get banged so damn hard, my ass will be heated, and I can call myself a pumpkin. Or alternative option, we are going to bang everyone with Tortoise DPM. This vehicle have humongous DPM and we can kill everyone, right? Pretty much there is two options. What I'm using for this tank, I'm using ventilation rammer optics. That's what I'm using. Let's go. Without further ado, fellas, we can start our journey. And the first battle, Overlord, two artists. This is going to be quite interesting experience, I guess. Okay, fellas, what the flying F we supposed to do in the Overlord? There is a couple of options. Option number one, I truly want to go somewhere art safe, because T92, if the T92 is going to hit me, I will take one for the team, and it's not going to be fun. If I'm going to get hit by the same GV Tiger, it's not going to be fun. Minus 500 guaranteed. So, what do we want to do, fellas? This is the question. I believe, fellas, we need to go somewhere in this area, right? So we can actually use our gun and our armor. We'll see. This is definitely not the best map for a Tortoise, but to be fair with you, all you need to do to have a good game to catch two tanks on tracks. If you are catching two tanks, you are getting already pretty much 4,000 damage, right? And my goal when I'm playing with a tier 9 tanks is 4,000 combined. So cross your fingers for me, fellas, and let's try to show the dominance. One tank which is quite similar for a Tortoise, speaking about the armor, mobility, and everything, is... T95 Aka Turtle, right? Or Doom Turtle, however you are calling that vehicle. Tortoise, it's a bit different thing. In my opinion, Tortoise have way shitter armor if people are shooting hits on you, right? If people are spamming gold, which is happening quite often nowadays. If people is not shooting gold ammunition, which is happening sometimes, then you are feeling quite fine. But to be fair with you, for me, those tanks which is relying purely on the armor or DPM, right? Well, armor slash DPM, they are slow. It's tricky for me to play with them. Probably it's not my style of the vehicle, fellas. Probably that's the case. Anyways, what is going to be the plan now? You see, there is E5, which is going to start peaking very, very soon. You don't believe in me, fellas? Believe in me. This E5 will think about peeking towards this T10 very, very soon. And whenever he is going to do that, we will immediately smack him. Watch this. Interesting. I have a feeling this E5 shit his pants. Oh, nope. Beautiful. Actually, not so beautiful. Unfortunately, I did not caught the track and I truly needed to do so. Oh, that's good. That's very good. Now pay attention into this angle which I am aiming. There is literally a pixel where I can track him and where I can do damage, right? And we are going to have a lot of fun, my lovely friends. How many repairs do you have, Mr. E5? That was quite interesting stuff. Anyways, he is dead. We have 500 damage, 400 assisting damage. Hip hip hooray. But now, if you would pay attention at the currency, mine. Can I track him, please? Unfortunately, I can't. And what we noticed that there is a Mr. Tortoise, actually stock Tortoise, which is sniping from the back. To be fair with you, I don't care about this guy at all whatsoever, fellas. Okay, what is the plan? We are going to make a hardcore pressure towards this 50 TP, right? Tier 9 Polish heavy tank. Okay, we got this, fellas, we got this. Believe me, this is only the start for us. Now, look, the fun things will start. So, Tishkevich is saying, Arta is hitting us for 400, not much what I can do about this, and our time to shine. Look at this, fellas. We are going to use our DPM to bang this guy like there is no tomorrow. And this is where Tortoise is actually shining. There is not a single bad thing what I can say about Tortoise right here, because look at this, how fast he is disappearing. I mean, that's just golden. That's pure gold, fellas. And once again, this is amazing situation. What is not so amazing? Not so amazing situation, fellas, whenever you are getting spotted and clickers are banging you without asking your name. This is not so good, right? Speaking about the Tortoise, hi, look. This guy, he have extremely good DPM, right? I believe it's not a big surprise. What do we want to do for this guy? We want to track him. I'm a simple man. All I need to do, I need to track him. Yes, I noticed this T10 and Arta. Yeah, this is the thing what I'm talking about. You are a humongous target, my lovely friends, for clickers, right? And once again, I got myself into quite a shitty ass situation right here when I was in the crossfire. So, first battle, quite Barnett pancake, if you would ask me. Only roughly 3,000 combined, which is not very, very good score for a tier 9 tank. I'm aiming all the time for 4,000. What happened right here? Well, Arta happened, fellas. Let's count the damage right here. GV Tiger minus 500 damage. By the way, you are moving on 20 kilometers per hour. After that, T95, 350 damage. So we lost pretty much half of our HP for Artas and we were stunned. So what do you expect me to do? By the way, if you would pay attention into my haircut, and Katita haircut, I believe we are looking literally the same. At least that's what I would say. Anyways, let's teleport into the other battle and let's have a good one, hopefully. And we are back, fellas. Victory, hip hip hooray, nice. It was not the best game ever, but you know what, this is going to be just fine for warming up, right? I hope the other games are going to be so much better than this one. I hope so. Anyways, once again, 1,800 damage, 900 assisting damage, definitely not the best battle in the world. Speaking by the damage, we are 6th. Speaking by experience, we are 2nd, so at least that's something. Let's keep moving. I want to get that game when we are going to burst everyone without even asking their name. This is the main goal what I want to see. And you know what we have here? Ooh, fellas, tier 8 matchmaking, only one Arta. That's actually very, very good. Can you imagine, fellas, we reach this stage when we are, only one Arta. Crazy situation currently in the game. Anyways, obviously I'm afraid of M50-55 for obvious reasons. After that, there is plenty of the heavy tanks. So overall, this battle have a huge potential. I believe it's definitely possible to get 6,000 to 7,000 combined like nothing. Let's see. Am I talking too much or am I capable to prove my actions, fellas? And capable to stand by my words? And before skill will get penetrated by Arta, right? And the lit on fire. Okay, so what do we want to do? Obviously, since Tortoise is slow meatball, we obviously want to go into the heavy line. There is not too many options unless there is 3 clickers in the game, right? Then you cannot play here. But if there is only one, I believe we can be very, very successful and we can play well. Whew. I'm excited, fellas. It's 20 kilometers per hour gameplay. What did you expect me to do? Dance naked as a stripper? What do you want me to do, fellas? On our way to position. You know what, fellas? If I would make myself a super skill, I believe... Ooh, hi there. Nice. Okay, you see? We spotted E75TS. And you know what is the best part of all this? He have a weak spot right there. There is a bloody horn what I'm aiming for. And there is a Patton. Nice. Okay, so how we are starting our battle? We are just trying to get some free damage right there. I'm a simple man, fellas. I just want free damage. Boop, boop. Couple of free shots right there. Look how this tank is shining, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. Look how this tank is shining right there. Whenever you have a chance to... You know what? I'm going on the 25x zoom because to aim to that horn is annoying. This is the horn where you want to aim. It's not the easiest hit ever, but believe me, everything is possible. Right there, you see that horn? This is a weak spot of the E75TS. Yes, absolutely, right there. And look at this DPM, how Tortoise is behaving right there. I could load high explosives and I could burn the hell, living hell out of him. You know what? For the sake of giggles and shits, look at this. High explosive on, boots minus 150 probably. Watch this, watch this, watch this. This is going to be just glorious. And schnai in the face, 85. You know what? I'm feeling completely fine. How is your day? Butts in the face for nothing. But I am spotting him, so at least that's something. Don't run, beautiful chicken. Minus 6, 164. Hello, buddy. I hope you are having a nice time. I don't know what he's trying to do right here, honestly. And it's not my problem. Puts minus 212. Puts another one. Now he's running for his life. He's saying, "Give this shit. I don't want to fight against the tortoise." And this is the best thing about the tortoise, my lovely friends. The DPM which you have is actually ideal and actually insane. If obviously you are able to use it, right? It's not happening every time, but if you are able to get some use of this, it's going to be amazing. So, moving on next. Oh, Wafflecock. Hi there. Obviously, we are missing the shot into the Wafflecock, which is a quite sad part if you would ask me, but oh well, what can we do? And now the question is, how do we want to make a pressure towards the enemy forces right here? How do we want to do that? This E75TS is showing his tiny cupola, but once again, in order to hit that, we need to work our ass off, fellas. We need to... Never mind. Never mind, fellas. Never worried. I said immediately. We are going to hit him. We are going to smack him. We are going to show dominance for him. And he is going to cry in the corner after all of this. Right? Beautiful. Meanwhile, what we figured out? We figured out Wafflecock is having a derp gun. And he's shooting hits. What that means for this tank? Whenever you are meeting a person which is actually willing to load gold, fellas, you are going to have such a horrible gaming experience, it's not even funny. Now watch this, high explosive on, schnai in the face, 600. Come here, you was bullying me, time to change positions. Schnai another one, 408 in the face. Definitely not a horrible performance, but you know what, fellas? We have only 4,500 combined right there. Shame. Could I play better? Probably I could. Probably I wasted way too much time with the E75TS, but you know, that's completely understandable. Speaking about the current gaming experience, fellas, have you ever noticed that we have a simulator of 15 to 1, 15 to 5? Yep. This is exactly what is happening. 15 to 3. Not a big surprise, being slow vehicle, we managed to pick up quite some shots, and there is quite a big chance we are going to be top 3 or maybe even top 2. I really doubt we are top by the damage, because heavy tanks and the heavy line, they had quite a bit of activity, but still, let's see how the things went for us. This is a tortoise gameplay. Either you are getting that lucky situation when you are farming everyone or not. So, 3,800 damage, 600 assisting damage. We are top by the damage and we are top by experience. That's what I'm talking about. This is the performance which I want to show, and tortoise is quite good at it. Tortoise is quite good at taking one for the team when people know how to deal with you, and Tortoise is quite good for hitting people in the face, especially for those guys which don't know how to penetrate you. If you are wondering what do you need to do against the Tortoise, that cupola on top right is extremely trollish. I can promise you that it is so damn trollish. It is insane how trollish it is. So how you are dealing with this? If you do not have a humongous penetration aka tier 9 tier 10 tank destroyer, and if you want to be competitive in a way, right, the best way is to do the things. Watch this fellas, pay attention right here. That's it, finito. Tortoise is dead. Tortoise is not even existing in the game. With all respect, this is how it goes. If you are a free-to-play player, or if you are not willing to spam gold left, right, and center, what you can do, obviously, you can try to aim for this cupola right here, but it is quite trollish shit. As an example, if you are playing with a Russian medium tank, right, you are going to eat this tank without even asking his name. You are going to have a good gaming experience in a way, and Tortoise is going to be not so good. But in the current world of tanks, fellas, it's just how it goes. It's just how it is working, my friends, right? Anyways, what we are doing here, as you can see, this matchmaking is glorious for us. 7 Yeves each side, although map is not the best. Tundra, right? Or how it's called. Yes, absolutely, Tundra. So, what is our goal? Slowly but surely, we'll going to position, right? That's what we want to do. Whenever we are going to arrive here, we are going to show dominance all over enemy heavy tanks which is playing around this area. Simple. To be fair with you, I am afraid only of probably Jack Tiger. I don't really care about anything else here. This is just fine. And as you can see, enemy 5120, he shit his pants, honestly. He's not enjoying his gaming experience, and he's thinking, where the flying F I am? That's what he's thinking, fellas. So, we are about to arrive to position where I always wanted to be, right? Good, very, very good, extremely good, very nice. And now look, I'm not going to pussy out right here. I'm going to make a pressure. Track. Beautiful. Now, since he cannot hit my cupola, he can go and eat Kaku. That's it. That's a perma track. Are you sure skill about it? Absolutely, yes. Have a nice day. Enjoy yourself. E75 is dead meat. Look what Tortoise can do for him. Once again, not asking his name and banging him. Look at this. E75 died in 20 to 30 seconds. That was quite funny, don't you think so? Hello there, cute meatball. He managed to penetrate us with a gold, which is completely fine. If I would be in his place, I would do literally the same thing. And here we go, he's dead. We cleared flank pretty much single-handedly. It was quite easy, fellas. Okay, what do we want to do now? Now we want to make a hardcore pressure in front, and hopefully we can get some use of all this. Speaking about some use, and speaking about the fears which I have, Jack Tiger. By the looks of it, Jack Tiger is stock, my lovely friends. What that means? That means he have lower alpha damage. Usually, top Jack Tiger have 560 alpha, now he have 490. But to be fair with you, it's not even worth my time to try to fight against him. It's just simply not worth it, right? So what we are doing, we are ignoring him, and we are looking at this IS-3-2 getting banged by our IS-3. If it's going to be the case, actually it's not going to be the case. I need to turn, dead. Here we go. Good. 3000 damage, 300 assisting damage. This is exactly what we want to see. And in a way, this battle is kind of equal, fellas. Holy bananas from Banana Land. Kind of equal battle. 6 to 5. Even Katita is saying I will scratch the flying gaff out of my chair. Okay, beautiful. So, what is going to happen next, fellas? You see, this eagle is politely saying, skill, do you mind? And I am saying, I don't mind. Harta, what the flying F is happening in this battle? Boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, what the flying F is happening? Okay, so let's start cleaning right here. Hellcat, he's screaming, he's running, and he is dead. Next. What do we want to do now? There is Arta right there and there is Eagle right there. Obviously, neither Arta, neither Eagle have a chance against us, so we are just simply going slowly in front. Slowly. Eagle is running for his life. He shit in his nest and he said, you know what, Clicker? You are going to take one for the team and I'm going to escape. Clicker is dead, Eagle is dead, another Clicker is hitting us, and here we go. This is the end of the story. Not bad performance whatsoever. We will try to rig Brother in Arms meanwhile, and we have 3,700 damage and 300 assisting damage. I mean, this is literally how the games with the Tortoise is looking like. You can score well even in the 3 minutes of the gameplays or the games, but enemies needs to make a pressure towards you, and then there is going to be no problem whatsoever, right? But if you are going into the flank where there is no enemies, believe me, in the end of the day the score is going to be quite shitty. And once again, nowadays when the score is 15-1, it's very, very, very hard to play with a slow fat tanks, just how it goes, and probably majority of you would agree with me. So, after 3 battles, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, by the way, this battle, we are second on the damage, which is completely fine, and we are second on experience, good. So, in this battle, in this session, fellas, we managed to get 3,100 damage and 600 assisting damage, which is not that bad. It could be better, but it's okay. I'm just accepting that, right? 3 victories. Remember yesterday, 3 battles, 3 defeats, and I was yelling like this. Today, completely different situation. Looks like today is going to be a good gaming experience. Thank you so much for watching, fellas. That was your daily dose of skill, and see you very, very soon. Peace.